गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम एंड डूइंग योर वर्क रेगुलरली. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन वन पोएम. बट बिफोर द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोएम, आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू आस्क समथिंग. हैव यू एवर बीन अ राइट ऑन एन एनिमल? इफ येस, then on which animal you have rode and what was your experience by doing riding on that animal. I hope you enjoyed a lot. So today we will do one such poem that will be very interesting for you all. So listen carefully. The poem is Elephant Ride. So students, first of all, I will read the lines in front of you so that you can judge, you can select the rhyming words and you can make the rhyming scheme with the use of the rhyming words. So this poem, Elephant Ride, is written, is composed by John Mason. John Mason has composed so many poems. He was an Anglican priest also. Elephant Ride is his famous poem. So today we will continue with this poem. On the highway, we stopped for tea at a rest house by the sea. Grassy lawns and shady trees, red tiled huts and scented breeze. So students, in the first stanza, the speaker want to say that the children were going on a hill station, but after a long drive, they all were tired. That's why they stopped on the highway to take some rest. So on the highway, there was a rest house which was near the sea. There they saw grassy lawns, yani hare bare bhagiche, shady trees, red tiled huts एंड सेंटर्ड ब्रीज. वहाँ का नज़ारा बहुत सुंदर था. रेस्ट हाउस समंदर के पास था, इसलिए हर तरफ ग्रासी लॉन्स थे, बड़े बड़े पेड़ थे, छायादार पेड़ थे, रेड टाइल्ड हट्स, छोटे छोटे घर बने हुए थे और बहुत सुंदर हवा चल रही थी, बहुत प्यारी हवा चल रही थी. दिस इज हेवन, वी ऑल क्राइड, स्ट्रेटनिंग अप फ्रॉम आर लॉन्ग राइड. देन वी सॉ ऑन अ हॉट हार्ड रोड a young bewildered elephant stood. So when the children were enjoying that scene, so they all were saying, this is very beautiful. They compared the scenery in the heaven, straightening up because they all were tired from the long drive. After some time, they saw a young bewildered elephant was standing on a hot hard road. थोड़ी देर बाद उन्होंने क्या देखा कि एक हाथी जो कि बहुत confused था, कहाँ पर खड़ा था? Hot hard road पर. With sad eyes and hurting feet, it rocked slowly in the heat. Ready for some tourists' fun, it stood drooping in the sun. The elephant was very sad and his feet were very hurting because he had to stand in the hot hard road for a long time. That is why he rocked slowly in the heat. क्योंकि वो पूरी तरह से थक चुका था, इतनी तेज़ धूप में वो मतलब ये फील कर रहा था कि अब उससे चला भी नहीं जा रहा था. But he always ready for tourist fun. पर फिर भी वो हर समय टूरिस्ट का इंजॉयमेंट करवाने के लिए तैयार रहता है, इतनी कड़ी धूप में भी खड़ा रहता है. नाउ अ नॉइजी बस केम इन, हूटिंग टूटिंग व्हाट अ डिन. द पैसेंजर्स ऑल टम्बल्ड आउट एंड रेन टू द एलिफेंट विद अ शाउट. उसी वक्त क्या होता है, एक अ नॉइजी बस केम इन. नॉइजी बस मीन्स, नॉइजी मीन्स मतलब फुल शोर शराबे से भरी हुई एक बस वहाँ पे आती है जिसमें बहुत सारे पैसेंजर्स होते हैं. दे ऑल वर कमिंग टू द एलिफेंट. with a full shout because they all want to take ride on the elephant. The next is, clutching their tickets, they clambered on, rumbled, tumbled, hambled on. Let's get moving, someone roared, hurry now, I'm getting bored. So students, in this stanza, the passengers hold their tickets tightly in their hands and they all want to climb on the elephant. So rumbled, tumbled, rumbled, tumbled means ek dusre ke upar chadh rahe hain, gir rahe hain, hampered on. Let's get moving, someone rode. उसके बाद जब कोई उसके उसके ऊपर बैठ जाते हैं तो वो कहते हैं हरी नाउ आई एम गेटिंग बोर्ड, अब जल्दी चलो मैं बोर हो गया हूँ. द एलिफेंट स्टार्टेड ऑन इट्स वे विद एवरी स्टेप इट सीम्ड टू से यू आर हैविंग फन इट गुड इट्स गुड टू सी बट कांट समबडी थिंक ऑफ मी. नाउ द एलिफेंट इज रेडी टू मेक दम फुल इंजॉय. So he started on its way. वो चलना शुरू कर देता है with every step it seemed to say. But अपने हर step के साथ वो ये कहना चाहता है you are having fun, it's good to see. I am happy because you all are having fun. But can't somebody think of me? क्या कोई मेरे बारे में नहीं सोच सकता? Here the elephant is saying about himself. Everyone is enjoying with his ride. बट नो बडी थिंक ऑफ हिम, कोई भी उसके बारे में, किसी ने भी उसके बारे में नहीं सोचा. सो बच्चों, इस कविता से हमें ये भी शिक्षा मिलती है कि हमें एनिमल्स की फीलिंग को भी समझना चाहिए. वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड द फीलिंग्स ऑफ एनिमल्स इवन दो दे ऑलवेज रेडी फॉर आर इन्जॉयमेंट. But we should feel their sorrows. We should feel their happiness. हमें उनके दुख को, उनकी खुशी को महसूस करना चाहिए क्योंकि animals also have emotions like humans. So always think of them. Clear? So students, I hope you all have cleared this poem and I hope you all will enjoy it. Now we will do one reference to the context so that you can select the rhyming words yourself and you can make the rhyming scheme with the use of that rhyming words. Now let's move on. So students, here I have taken one reference to the context. Reference to the context means here I have taken one stanza and I have written some questions for you all so that you can select the rhyming words and make the rhyming scheme and you can note down how we have to attempt the reference to the context in the exam. Clear? So firstly you have to read the stanza. On the highway we stopped for tea at a rest house by the sea. Grassy lawns and shady trees, red-tiled huts and scented breeze. So, I hope you all have understood. This is the first stanza of the given poem. Now, I have written some questions like who composed this poem? I already explained. John Mason composed this poem. Who composed this poem? John Mason composed this poem. Clear? So, this poem, इस पोइम को किसने कंपोज किया है? जॉन मेसन ने. सो व्हाट विल बी द आंसर ऑफ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन? दिस पोइम इज कंपोज्ड बाय जॉन मेसन. क्लियर? या यू कैन राइट लाइक जॉन मेसन कंपोज्ड दिस पोइम. इज दैट क्लियर? नाउ द सेकेंड इज राइट द राइमिंग वर्ड्स फ्रॉम द गिवन स्टैंजा. गिवन स्टैंजा मीन्स दिस द फोर लाइन्स विच यू हैव गिवन. यू हैव टू सेलेक्ट द राइमिंग वर्ड्स फ्रॉम द गिवन स्टैंजा. So students, what will be the rhyming words? Rhyming words will be have the same sound. Same sound means like tea, sea, trees, breeze. These are the rhyming words. Here you can see tea and sea have the same sound. Trees and breeze have the same sound. So the rhyming words will be TC, trees, breeze. Clear? Now, next question is, what is the rhyming scheme of the given stanza? What will be the rhyming scheme? So students, here some students get confused ki rhyming scheme hoti kya hai. So every time, whenever you have to make the rhyming scheme, you have to choose the rhyming words firstly. Because if you have selected the rhyming words, in that situation you can make the rhyming scheme correctly. Clear? Like here you can see T, C, trees, breeze. So students, first of all, the rhyming words always starts with A. Clear? So this will be A. A is the first sound of the first line. Clear? आपने ये नहीं देखना कि यहाँ पे टी ई ए ए लास्ट में दिया है तभी हमने ए लिया है. नो, यू हैव टू सपोज यहाँ पे आपको रोड वर्ड भी दिया है तब भी आपने फर्स्ट वर्ड को क्या लेना है, अ वर्ड लेना है. ठीक है, अ साउंड देना है. बिकॉज द टी एंड सी आर द सेम वर्ड्स, सो इन द नेक्स्ट लाइन दैट अगेन इज अ. बिकॉज दीज टू वर्ड्स आर हैव सेम साउंड. So if the first is A, then the second will be A. Clear? Then after that you have to change the rhyming word, rhyming scheme. Clear? Like, because trees is different from C and T, so in that situation it will be B. Clear? So this sounds B. If trees and breeze have the same sound, then B also have the sound B. Clear? So now the rhyming scheme will be a b b. So the rhyming scheme of the given stanza is a b b. Is that clear? Okay, the next question is, what did the speaker see at the rest house? Speaker ne rest house mein kya dekha? Kya dekha? They saw the grassy lawn, shady trees, red tiled huts. The speaker saw the grassy lawns, shady trees and red tiled huts at the rest house. So students, I hope you all have cleared. So students, I hope you all have cleared this poem and you all have understood how you can select the rhyming words and how you can make the rhyming scheme of the stanza. Now if you have any doubt, then you can contact me on my personal number anytime and I will re-explain this poem in the Zoom class also. If you have any doubt, then you have to note that doubts in your notebook and send to your class in charge at least 2 days prior. Clear? So stay home, stay safe. Thank you. God bless you all.